acrobatic paragliding is kind of a dance for me in the third dimension. When I pull the brake to take speed and enter a strong maneuver, this is a very conscious moment in my life. I need to discipline my body and my mind to be able to dance with my glider together.
The paraglider, just a piece of textile, nylon and some lines, but you can do amazing stuff with it in the air.
My name is Pál Takáts. I grew up in this city, Budapest, the capital of Hungary. About 10 years ago, I walked on this bridge and I saw many little points flying over that mountain. They were paragliders. I didn't know anything about this sport, but I knew I have to do it. And a few years later, I find myself competing in the Acro World Cup Series, and with my friend Gábor, Kézi, we made kind of good results.
Our story starts here. We learn to fly on these little hills.
Still amazed how simple and pure our flying tool is, that you can just pick up your 20 kilo bag with a complete aircraft in it and go to the takeoff, open up in 5 minutes and fly really free like a bird, just using the power of nature, thermals and wind. You can fly hundreds of kilometers away or fly really far somewhere and return back. It's an amazing sensation. Most of the pilots are flying cross-country, but there is a growing minority who is interested in aerobatics flying.
If we are talking about acro, we have to mention two names, Raul and Felix Rodriguez. They are the founding fathers of acro, two brothers from Spain, who are kind of the biggest example in front of me since I've started acro flying.
No, first it was not calling acro, it was just calling crazy stuff. I don't know how they call it, not really acro. The name of acro came really the day Raul Rodriguez and I, we created the SAT team. It was the beginning of the acro. And around 98, 99, Raul found the SAT. And this maneuver was the beginning of everything. Because Raul already, when he got the SAT, he already got the idea. He knew it would become tumbling. He knew already. Everything was already in his head. He knew because of his figure, the rest will follow.
I'm going to perform some acro tricks for you guys to see how it works. So, let's go. We'll be right back. hour there are more than 20 maneuvers. There are three maneuvers which are the really basic of acro paragliding. These are wing overs, the helicopter maneuver, and the SAT. So I'm going to show first these basic maneuvers. All the other tricks are only the combination of these three maneuvers. I start with the wing over. I'm making the other, but every time to the inside, making and body shifting. As the more energy I take, the higher I can go. The second are the slow maneuvers and the speed maneuvers. The helicopter is the actually a perfectly controlled spin. The glider is turning like a helicopter rotor. It's a really, really sensible maneuver. I have to follow the glider's movement every time with my body and the brakes. And the third maneuver I told about is the SAT. I'm now changing it directly to it. This maneuver changed radically the history of paragliding after Raul Rodriguez invented it in 1999, because it opened really new dimensions. I'm going to perform an infinity tumbling maneuver. It is nowadays the newest and the most difficult acro maneuver. I'm going to swing above the middle of the glider many times with a lot of energy. I enter a glider into a very steep spiral. Small correction in each turn to keep the glider straight in a perfect 180 degrees angle, otherwise it collapses and loses energy like this, and I have to stop for this reason.
For many years, the acro competitions were dominated by the SAT team. They were always ahead of all the pilots, they won all the competitions. And they were very lucky to have a beautiful training spot in Spain, it's called Organa, where there are a lot of flyable days each year. And if there is a flyable day, you can just make all the day, a lot of runs.
We are on the Hármas Határhegy, the free flying center of Budapest. And this is the place, these are the hills, or here we call them mountains, where we learn to fly. And this is a really typical Hungarian flying site with an altitude difference of 50 or 80 or 100 meters. Thank you.
most of the successful pilots are coming from a high mountain region, like the Alps. These guys live in a house where they just step out the front door and they have these high mountains with perfect conditions for acro practice.
Hungary is basically flat. To get nice altitude for an acro training, it's a nice opportunity for us to join our base jumping friends and jump out of a hot air balloon.
I think all the pilots arrive to a point once where their hobby turns to a real passion. And this is the point where after you cannot really study anymore, you cannot concentrate on your work anymore because you are just looking out the window and looking the clouds in the sky and checking the wind if it's, you're really waiting for the time to go to fly and you are, this is the only thing you want.
Soon we grew out the Hungarian topography, so we had to discover the legendary acro sites. Our first stop was the Galica mountain, where we could go to the top by a cable car, and finally we could practice our maneuvers safe above water.
When I saw these guys flying the first time, I thought, well, yeah, these are young guys trying, they are very motivated to make acro and stuff, but I never thought that they would be, once upon a time, one of the best pilots in the world. And I told them everything I knew about acro.
We wanted to learn more and more. So we traveled to the competitions, met all the pilots, and it was the point where everything just began.
Raul was real hero for us, and we watched all the available movies on the internet about him and tried to catch all the tricks, how to do the maneuvers. So we were really excited in 2005 when we had the possibility to meet him and all the SAT team. At the end of the 2005 season, they were telling us about a place in Spain called Organa, that it's the perfect place to train acro.
In the summer of 2006, we spent 2-3 months in Organa, really long time. We did a really, really fast progression, and at the end of the season, we finished 4th in synchro, and I finished 7th in solo in the World Championship.
I was last year very, very impressed about Pál Takáts, because this guy made some so pure runs at the end of the season. In Italy, he was so great, he was better in some tasks. He was better than Raul and better than Felix.
When our results were becoming better and better, we realized that maybe we can beat the SAT team. So it was a very big challenge for us to take our examples and then finally be better than them.
When I started to do acrobatics, It was like there is almost no maneuvers, you know? And it takes a lot of time to get new maneuvers, to think about new maneuvers, to try new maneuvers, and to set it all up. And also the wings, and we had to find out what size is good. We went smaller and smaller and smaller with the wings, and we tried to do wings especially for aerobatics. And young people come, young guys like Pál and Gábor and others, they come and they can progress super quick.
Travel around Europe all summer long, it costs something like 5,000 euros each. Pál found a job as an industrial alpinist, and I was working in our family business to earn this money.
At the moment, we are in the beginning of a new season, a whole year, and this is now the most stressful and most difficult part.
Traveling with small cars, it's a hassle. We had to find a van.
At the moment, we are searching for the ideal van for us. And I still don't know about how it will be financed, but we will get one for sure. Szerelem átzuhan a falakon, és zavartan azt üvölti, hogy hello. Egymásnak esnek az égi testek valahol. Ha a holdon dobol egy kobold, ruhában én vagyok, mint kergelek, kék köribém gyűlnek a méreten aluli angyalok. Ja, csak a szívem, a szívem, a szívem szakadtól. This is the beginning of the season and now we are heading to Organya. We are fully charged with a lot of motivation and we want to win all the competitions.
Capteur, je sais pas si j'ai rien exprimé comme il faut. Oui. Ce petit capteur, il compte toutes les fois que le moteur tourne.
The cost of the repair took almost all of our budget. Our only chance to finish our tour is to win some prize money on the competitions. Here we are in Organya, the weather is getting worse. My tent is getting fulfilled with water. And we need to train for the first comps. But we are just getting wet. Thank you.
Back when I was young, I had these dreams that I jump with the ski. I dreamt many times I jump with the ski and I make huge jumps, man. And somehow I always landed soft. And when I was started to speed riding, I saw, man, I remembered that dreams. And I said, fuck, I dreamt about this.
Just 9 months after Matthias told us about speed flying and his childhood dreams, he passed away in a speed flying accident in March 2008. Of course, in every extreme sport, the top athletes are really pushing the limits to achieve higher and higher levels. So fatalities and accidents occur. I also had one time a near-death experience with Matthias when in summer of 2007 we crashed into each other really, really badly in a synchro session. We both landed safe and without any scratches. It linked us together as friends, I think. After this, it was really, really sad to hear what happened, and I was crying for a long time after that.
Finally, the weather is just perfect. And I'm going to make a freestyle synchro session with Matthias. Helicopter, and he is coming to make a spiral around me. Come on, kiss me! Yes! It was very, very close. And he's coming again now! Yeah, okay! Oh. We fucking crashed into each other, man. I'm going to land with the rescue just now. Soft landing! It's okay, it's okay! Oh man, I'm okay.
We are alive, man.
Oh man.
Fuck, man. It's really fucking hot. It's really, really fucking hot.
He entered the set from the double spiral, what I didn't expect. And I was a little bit too close. We were too close to each other. And it just was the wrong timing and we hit each other. I thought we go for another touch, and then I just see he pull into the sod, and I just see his wing comes like shh, bam, and hits me like that, and I just see the wing, and I go like no, and then I feel already the lions are around me. In moments like this, you have no time to think. It's just like you are in the situation, and somehow for me it was not. You don't judge the situation. You don't think like oh, bad, that shit now. You just look, and everything becomes slow, man.
10 days after the crash, we were heading to the summer's most important competition, the pre-world championship in Norway.
Sorry, sir. Don't do it.
Thanks.
Podium, you can only see smiling faces, happy pilots hugging each other, but there are sometimes tensions in the background.
The relationship between us and the SAT team and also Raul has changed from like one day to the other. They told us to go away, to let them train there alone before the first world championship.
I think it was new for them to feel that other people come and can beat them.
Before of the Mundial, I was really hard to be in the top and to win the competition. After the Mundial, I do my best. I get the first place in synchronized, the third place in solo. So it was like a finish the University of Acrobatic Paraglider, no? And it was really good. Now, I wanna take a part of the competition, but I don't want to feel like fighting with the others.
Of course, acro flying is a little bit dangerous. A small mistake is enough and you can fall into the canopy or the lines. However, we have reserve parachutes. It's still not guaranteed that you will land unhurt. For safety reasons, all the competitions are held over water.
acrobatic competition, there are two categories, the solo and the synchro. In the solo, each pilot performs their maneuvers alone, and in synchro, two pilots fly together. The maneuvers, the choreography, and the landing are scored by the professional jury. Whoever gets the most points wins the competition.
And we know from the last years, and especially last year, they made really, really nice synchro. And then this year, of course, after training, all the teams will be a big fighting between us.
Summer of 2007, the competition arena became really tight, close, which was unusual before. All the pilots were getting really close to each other, just with half or 1-1 points. And in the most important competition in Norway, in the first compulsory task, Antoine finished first, Raoul second, and I was third, just 2 points behind Antoine.
How much?
0 to 5 kilometers.
0 to 5. Ah,
so
okay.
No wind.
Yeah.
And you can start in. 2 minutes.
Perfect.
Okay.
The most difficult part in a competition when you have to wait more hours on the takeoff, and then you have to give your best on those 3 minutes when you are performing your run.
Alejandro is in his fourth maneuver, the helicopter.
In the second solo run in Norway, Raul Rodriguez, world champion, made a perfect job. He had a really nice flight with perfectly clean maneuvers, and he won the run with more than 93 points, which is really a lot for a solo run. I finished second, just 3 points behind. Of the competition, we had some rainy bad days with cold weather, and I also catched a cold and got fever, and I woke up on the last day preparing for the final run. I felt really calm and quiet, but I had not much energy because I was sick, and as the time of the run was getting closer and closer, also my concentration level raised till the very top. Despite I was really sick and weak, I made a perfect flight and I won the task and finished third overall after Raoul and Antoine.
Second place in a pre-world championship, I think it's a very nice result.
And standing on the podium after 5 really hard days with a lot of pressure and stress, and then you are just standing there and smiling and
it's really a special moment for me.
After Norway, we returned to Spain, Organa. All the pilots were there training for the next competition.
Flight time!
Liberar más.
No, al revés.
Esta y luego la segunda suelto.
Every day we spend 5-6 hours in the air training, and on one sunny day, the travel arrives.
Like I broke my backbone. It happened yesterday. It was a regular training day in Organa, and I was training for asymmetric set, and when I entered one line was broken in my paraglider, and I thought I can easily land. But when I reached above the landing field at 20-25 meter height, my glider suddenly stalled and I crashed into the ground.
Of course, we saw each other throwing a lot of rescues and having a lot of risky situations. You just see what's happening and you hope, you pray that the rescue will open and he will land safely.
After Gábor's accident, we were all really scared, but fortunately his backbone fracture was not so serious and he could leave the hospital in 1 week without a surgery. But of course he was not allowed to fly at least for 2 or 3 months.
My fear was that he would choose another synchro partner because of this has happened to me. But finally I had to realize that this accident didn't change anything in our relationship or in our flying.
After Norway, Raul announced to leave the competition arena. It was a really, really big surprise for all the scene and the community. Was told that he's going to focus more on his job in a paraglider manufacturer company as a test pilot and designer.
Without me, Pál focused on his solo flights. I could really feel that he wants to win. He could win all the tasks and make very spectacular ground spiral with the wingtip touch. I was very amazed of his flight. So he won all the tasks, miles ahead, everyone.
Although Gábor had to take a break between the competitions, we made really, really nice results after he returned. And we finished second in the overall synchro World Cup ranking. And I won the World Cup in 2007.
success changed our life. We have sponsors who stand behind us, that we are able to live the lifestyle what we have dreamt about. I spent the winter in South America, and Pál moved to a place where he can fly whenever he wants. In the spring of 2008, we were in very good shape, and our plan was to make a real big hit in the acro scene during the competition season. But then there was a barrier, an accident again.
In February 2008, with my girlfriend, we moved here to Interlaken, the heart of Switzerland. And I think if somebody have ever visited this region, it's easy to understand our decision. It's a real paradise for extreme sportsmen. And it was really a long-awaited dream of me to move somewhere, to live in a place where I can really leave all my sports, from rock or mountain climbing through skydiving or paragliding and water sports, whatever. Everything is perfect here, it's just perfect. I don't have a lot of memories from the day of the accident. I have some pictures that we are going to the hospital and we are there waiting, and I was just asking and asking the same questions again and again and again, that is my ankle broken? Really, really? And after the 2 minutes I was asking again, is my ankle broken and they are going to make an operation? Oh shit, the whole season is gone, oh shit. I even cried, of course. We took off with Gábor from the top of the cliff, flew out over the valley and practiced a nice new choreography that we were training for the first competitions. After the run, I flew over the landing place, started the grand spiral, and I was approaching quite fast, and I just went too low over the grass, which was a bit too high. My wingtip caught the flowers and just bang, stopped the leading edge, crashed with the ground, and soon after I also crashed with the ground.
People from the cable car, they came and they thought they should bring me some strong painkillers because it's so painful, I'm shouting, but I was not shouting because of the pain, but because of just disappointment.
I immediately thought about the whole season, that it's gone, and I cannot fly the whole summer, I cannot train, I cannot go with Gábor. Raul and Felix and the SAT team was the first generation of the acro pilots, the founders of most of the figures. Now here comes the second generation with me and a lot of other young pilots. And we have to work together for one goal, to make our sport popular.
We are at Geneva Airport. We are going to have the biggest show in our life. There are already 500,000 people waiting for our show. I think it's going to be the biggest show ever made in paragliding history.
A few years ago, we were just beginner pilots playing on the Hungarian hills, and we had a dream to grow up to the top level of the acro paragliders, and we could manage in 3 years. We did a really fast progression, and now here we are in Geneva. It's a beginning of a new era for us to reach more people and bigger events and to make a real profession out of our hobby and passion. And I think this is the first step today on this way.
It's not protesting. People are giving the answers as some kind of solution.